I was saying something about how I wasn't quite familiar with the system. Keto's starting. Awesome. Here come the bands. But yeah, basically I accidentally typed, I may be just taking a shit in the dark. Luckily, before posting it, I took a look and was like, oh, I mean shot in the dark, not shit in the dark. But it was a little Freudian, I guess.
Happens to me at work all the time.
You take shits in the dark?
Yep. You know, government.
It's pretty kinky, dude. Government. Yeah, I could see that.
All right, so we got a Renekton ban from ResNet, and Sex Panther's got a Trindamir ban.
Both great champs for really making you angry when you're trying to kill them. Varus and Jarvan.
Let's see what we got. So, Jarvan is definitely a top played champion for Sex Panther. And you know the matchup that was that they last had? Let me see if I can find it here. Sex Panther and Resident OP. It was, well, you know, they actually played Taric in that last matchup. For Sex Panther.
Were
but
the,
I actually don't see many of the people that actually they're banning that were... they had a much different setup from their usual ones for Sex Panther.
Yeah, I don't always understand the ban's mentality, but I usually understand the actual banning of the characters, because... I usually hate all the characters in Japan.
I can see the Wukong. The Wukong is like is also another top player for ResNet, or top chosen champion. So, yeah, he's pretty nasty up top.
He really is. And we saw a couple games ago, we saw where Wukong was able to just get away at the last second using his W that creates the Shadow Clone. And prevent himself from getting killed at least twice, probably three times. And that, you know, really gave his team an advantage.
So long, long decision here for ResNet.
They're thinking hard.
Yeah, it's a tough decision. You're going up against first place, basically.
He could also be like in the bathroom or something, and we just think he's thinking hard, and he doesn't actually give a crap.
He was. Shitting in the dark.
Gross.
We all do it at some point in our lives.
Squall locked in with Lulu almost immediately.
He knows what he wants. I mean, who plays Lulu?
Only people who just, like, you know, have no life.
We like to make our inside jokes, don't we?
Ooh, we might see a Lulu, oh, never mind. I see how it is. As soon as the caster gets excited about a pick, yeah.
What was it going to be? Lulu and...
Jinx.
Yeah, that's our combo. Patented.
Yeah, I like Lulu Jinx. That is fun.
We patented it. They're not able to do it. You know, they have to pay the trademark.
I wish that's how that worked.
Oh, that would be horrible.
Oh, God, yeah.
Sona. Sona and Vi.
Give it like a year or two. I'm sure Disney will figure out a way to patent it.
Alright. Oh, that was an instant pick. Going for Syndra. Alright. And
Vi can be a great pick. She can be a pretty powerful top. We've seen Issues play a pretty good Vi. I don't think I remember seeing Verkado play one, though.
I was getting all excited when I saw Grandma pick Skarner. I haven't seen Skarner in the matchups yet. He's fun.
He is. Does he say... What does he say? Not get over here. When he starts pulling people.
I think he says something somewhere.
Feel my sting!
That's it.
kind of gross. Like, he's like getting off on like sticking his stinger in people. Just like one of my Japanese animes.
Oh my. I had to take that in for a second.
That's what you said.
Oh, man. All right. Syndra, gonna be a crazy mid. Yeah, we haven't seen Sivir much.
We really haven't.
And with our new changes, for top, should be interesting. I think they added back the W is a little bit more useful now with the bounces again.
Yeah. Okay. But, yeah, I remember them nerfing that really hard because it was ridiculous.
Oh, I loved that, but yeah, it was a little overpowered. They, you know what is interesting? They made her so that it just looks physically impossible the way she's looking in that picture, her loading picture.
Oh yeah, isn't like her hips are twisted weird or something?
She's like bent over like a, she kind of bends like a. Maybe like a triangle or something.
I'm sure we'll see it in a second. I do want to.
She's actually just a paperclip.
He might have a skin.
Oh.
Also, the new Vi skin, it looks awesome, but that image bothers me because, like, the way her leg twists, it should be breaking. Like, it's coming out from her waist and the hips facing towards you. And then by the time it's on the ground, the angle is completely, her ankle is completely perpendicular to her thigh. So there's no way her foot is bending the way it should be without snapping. It's really creepy. But it's still an awesome skin.
I'm sure we'll see in this in the next few minutes.
Maybe if Ricardo doesn't have it. Maybe he doesn't like to support Riot.
Oh, maybe.
That was the first skin, though, where I was like, oh, God. Oh, Riot, take my money.
That is not the first skin. You've said that multiple times.
No, that's the only time I've said that. The only other time I bought
a skin... I call shenanigans.
Was because... I think it was Blood wanted to play an all-pirates game. So I bought the pirate skin for Tristana. That was back when I only played Tristana. Then Tom gifted me a Lulu skin. And those were the only two skins I had.
So while we're waiting, we can look at the brackets real quick. See what's going on. This is what the playoffs are going to be like. The next coming weeks, you can see the dates on there, I think. So tonight we'll have ResNet and Sex Panther, as you saw. And then next Tuesday... we'll have Miyagi versus Four Pony, and then we should see who's gonna face up in round two there, basically. And we'll handle the losers bracket and the two Tuesdays from now on both on December 3rd, or I'm sorry, three Tuesdays because we're skipping Thanksgiving week. And then the final matchup we'll have on December 5th, and should be interesting. So everybody's been pretty close. Looking at the standings so far, all teams have been pretty much within like one game of each other, with Miyagi and Four Pony tying up for second.
I was looking at this and I was a little sad because, you know, the one thing that was good about our team was our icon. Our icon looks sweet. So it would be awesome if you could like take the question mark blocks and replace those with just our icon.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Well, because everyone knows. I mean, it might as well be a question mark. It's the same idea because they'll look at the image and, like, you know, they'll be like, what?
I don't understand.
Yeah, exactly. So it's the same meaning as a question mark. You know, it's just... an image of the front fell off guy instead.
All right. So, what do you think about this build, this lineup, this matchup?
I think it's going to be pretty solid. Sona's definitely going to help out bottom. you know, just keeping everybody healed up.
With us,
they
yeah.
don't really, they don't really have a healer on purple.
Actually, you think Ez is gonna be bottom, and then I guess Lucian up top.
I would think so, yeah. But they might. Excuse me, they might swap that.
And then Grandma's pretty nasty as Hecarim, if I recall. Grandma's just nasty.
The Pony of Death.
Lulu and, yeah, so Lulu and what? Lulu and Silver.
Yeah,
bottom?
Just standard Vi skin. Oh, well.
Yeah, there we get to see the Silver skin. The crazy normal Silver skin where she's like.
Yeah, she's just. How's that supposed to work? Not to mention, like, with the size of her giant blade that she's twirling, like, the other blade has to be stuck in her hip.
Or is about to be.
Yeah.
So Syndra mid, Shen top, I guess, and then Sivir and Lulu bottom. Yeah, that makes sense. And then, so Shen with double teleport. That's pretty nasty. We've seen that before from Sex Panther.
Mm-hmm. That is really nasty.
It's a pretty common strategy. And then, yeah, I don't know who's got the advantage of the build here. I think Hecarim's a much better, much stronger, or can be a much stronger jungler.
Yeah, he can be. Than Vi. But the nice thing about Vizel is that it'll stop someone that you're going after, and you know, it's basically a mini stun. Cool. At least for a second. Meanwhile, Hecarim pushes people away, which, you know, has lost people many a kill.
He can chase, though.
So she at least has a little bit of a ganking advantage. Also, Frosted Ezreal, is that a breakfast cereal?
It is now. No.
Yes.
Also,
that should be like the gift that Riot gives out at some future.
Some I just thought about that. That name is really creepy.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, like, I can't think of any application for that term that doesn't involve terribly written lemon fan fiction.
Looks like fuck it just said fuck it and it finally loaded.
Nice.
But I might have to give him the toaster award.
Oh, yes. I love me some toasters. Already starting my second beer.
Man, you're on a rush, man. What are you going to do?
I accidentally
we have to last all night, you know.
I accidentally got these mini beers that are 8 fluid ounces. And it's awful. So I have to, like, drink 3 in order to get even a beer's worth of beer.
That's
not to mention it's Bud.
Terribly sexy.
That's terribly sexy.
Both invading for both red. I think... Both
is this
get
the
red.
New meta? Do teams just take each other's jungle
yep.
now?
Yeah. That's the thing, man.
I feel like it's just stupid.
It'll be interesting. Supposedly the jungle changes for next season. Wonder if this will change up.
You know, that's a good point. I remember when there wasn't meta. Those were good times.
What are you, a hipster?
I know, right? Game feels a little quiet, says Twitch chat. You should just respond, what?
The game feels quiet.
The game? I just lost. God damn it.
No!
I gotta be that guy. There's blue taking red.
Shen saw them, but I guess backed up, I think.
Maybe. Well, Kazu leaving that last minion.
Blue gets red. Purple gets blue. I think there's deeper meaning in that.
Bruises? Dangly parts?
That show. I missed
it. Oh, that pink one.
Oh, man, up top. Already ganked from Vi. Level 2. Shen is
wow,
down
almost
to...
Got him.
He's down to 120.
Almost got Fock.
Fock.
Fock. Hecarim going into the jungle. Looks like he's going to be able to take red here. Fancy man.
They got to fight at bottom already.
Wow, and so away like... with 5 health.
Sex Panther's doing a good job bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and top. They might be able to get a kit Riven there. Yes. First blood goes to Shen.
Vi looking at her red and going, uh-oh.
Here comes Lucian.
Coming
gonna,
bot.
Yeah, Lucian's going to try and take him out here. I don't think he's going to get enough hits off on the tower. Hecarim is able to avoid getting hit from the tower, but, oh, a kill on Lulu that goes to no one. And there's a kill for, first kill for ResNet. Picking up the Hecarim kill.
Yeah, that was a good good catch on Vi's part. It was good she was in the area. She might be coming around to get a kill on Thinkar.
Yeah, she does. Sivir dropping down to 200 health now. Barrier up. I don't think Vi's going to be able to get enough hits off before the tower. She's going to dive. And there she goes.
Wow.
ResNet now picking nice, up and catching up to 2-2.
Yeah, both kills for her, too. She might be able to get a little fed. These purple minions are really relentless. Just following Keto everywhere. But trying to put some words down, but too many pinks. Syntra's currently highest on minions right now. I don't think she's gone back yet either. What's she doing on gold? 900, not too bad.
Syndra, yeah, let's see. She's got 33, and, oh, actually, Shen and Riven both getting pretty low up there.
Here comes Hecarim. So he's not gonna be able to do anything really here.
Riven staying pretty solid at, a little under half health. Vi setting up for ganks. Not pushing. Syndra's not pushing out far enough though at the moment. Gonna try to sneak in. Hecarim tries to set up again for another gank. Riven sees it. Tries to taunt him out.
The laughs.
Meanwhile, bottom. ResNet's pushing pretty hard at bottom now.
Meanwhile,
in the Legion of Doom.
Lucian doing a decent job of getting those last hits right there.
Yeah, he's doing a good job. He's got both of them down to half health already.
Yep. Finkar, though, keeping ahead on the creep score. Hecarim setting up top. I do not think a dive there would go well for him.
I think Hecarim is kind of wasting XP at this point.
A lot of time. Absolutely.
Yeah. He should be out jungling. He sat there for a while, was waiting for that setup, but didn't make anything of it. Lulu warding the tribe bush now.
Yeah, with a pink even. Trying to make sure they have domination when it comes to that vision of the map.
Well, they had had Vi come through there a couple times already, so.
That's a good point.
And they've been pushed back that far back already before too. Vi is stealing red again. And she's getting taking advantage of that. Ezreal's ult bottom takes both Sex Panther's players down to half health. Maybe about third, actually. And
yeah,
Vi setting up to come in behind on Shen. She's gonna get the hit off on him. And both are gonna be able to take him out. Shen's going the wrong way, yeah. Yeah, he's gonna try and port. He's not gonna get away, though.
Nice. Ooh, good stun there from Gravitas. Gravitas?
Oh, not
wow.
Even good syndromes. Hecarim was able to get
nice
the kill,
Hecarim.
Though. Yeah. Well played. I think they might even be able to get Riven here. She's just walking. She's trapped there. So two kills there
really
for Sex Panther.
Really good part there.
For Shen. In place of Shen, that is.
Only 700 gold difference. Pretty much, you could chalk that up to pretty much just that kill that they're ahead.
Yeah, see, they got a 432 gold from getting rid of Bracato's killing spree, so yeah.
Bottom for Sex Panther already starting to take some hits. They're at half health, a little bit more than half health, or a little bit less than half health for that tower.
Pretty close, all in all. 3-4 in favor of Sex Panther at the moment.
Thinkar already got a pickaxe and a vampiric scepter. Ooh, looks like they're gonna be able to get
Sona might go down. Here she goes! Lucian. Exhausted, he flashes away.
Ooh,
he's going
flash.
Down to 300 health. Barriers up. Kill from Sivir.
Wow, that was a great ult by Lulu. Just barely saving Thinkar there. That tower might have gotten her.
That's a good support.
Oh, yes.
Ezreal and Riven and Shen fighting up top. Riven goes down to about 400 health. Shen just tanking it all at this point. Probably can. Sex Panther going for Dragon now. Vi sees it, can't really do much. Ezreal tries to ult and steal it, but it's a little too early.
He almost got Grandma with that.
Pretty close. Riven now dropping Shen down to 100 health. He's not going to get that kill at the moment. Might be out to die the tower, but Shen's running away.
She's diving. He's running.
Meanwhile,
in the Legion of Doom,
I think we should kill them all.
Oh, someone just misses going in after Sivir there. We've been able to get top down to a little under a quarter health.
Minion's still doing damage to it.
Yeah, it's down to 200. That's pretty close. A couple hits and that's done. Three at bottom for Resnet. They might get bottom here. Sivir's trying to get back to the tower. I don't think they're going to be able to stop her. Sona ulti. Sivir's down the middle of three of them. They're going to be able to get that kill.
Nice.
And Lulu tries to come in and maybe take out Sona? No, she's going to try to take the minions though. That puts it 4-6 for us and Sex Panther in the lead. They've got about a 1.5k lead.
Still not too much, although I like that Sivir is getting a good chunk of the kills. That's definitely helping her out items-wise. Meanwhile, Lucian actually has BF Sword on top of Vampiric Scepter. That's pretty powerful. A good combo. Not to mention he's got Duran Duran.
Oh, yeah. Might be on the hunt with fuck, I forget the rest of the song.
Sorry,
and I'm gonna stop there. Something on fire and on the hunt after you, something, forget it. Okay,
that's right. I'm on the hunt, I'm after you. That was they sang that in Futurama. Zach Brannigan's like, yeah, let's sing my favorite songs from the 80s. Just like, which 80s? The only 80s I know.
Meanwhile, in the jungle, Syndra and Vi do a little tuffle.
Hustle.
Started down to half health. Lucian,
you saying she's a hustler?
They'd be hustling.
You calling her a hussy?
You're a hussy.
Why do we have so many words that use that general pattern?
Lucian and Sona at half health, and yeah, Sex Panther can push him pretty hard. But Vi's gonna come in at top, take Sivir down to half health. They don't have a tower here to fall back on, but Resnet's gonna back off.
I feel like that wasn't the best time to ult from Vercado. His teammates weren't close enough to be able to really secure the kill. Although his cooldown on that is like 90 seconds, so might as well use it when you can, I suppose.
Might have been a little miscommunication.
On their team? No. They've managed to accomplish complete synergy.
Synergy. Ezreal gets stunned at mid. Syndra going after him, gets him down to about a quarter health. He flashes out.
Flash.
Double flash. Syndra gets her. So freaking close for Ezreal. And still gets a kill. At bottom, Sona's gonna drop now to Hecarim. Oh no! Sona might get away here. She might get the kill. She does. She does not get away though. Lucian trying to get Lulu. So close. She gets down to.
Like
about 30
health there.
I think, alright, 25 maybe?
Yeah. That was crazy.
Now 9-5 in the favor of Sex Panther. And they got Hecarim,
really,
but they lost
the level of play we just saw there, both mid and bot. Really good,
Vi trying to walk off Sivir from taking that tower.
Yeah. Some great mechanics there. I really liked Syndra's ability to pick up on the flash, react quickly enough to then flash over herself and ignite. Just barely taken Ez there. I mean, that was really close. Very solid. So Sex Panther now up by 4 kills and 2k gold.
Yeah, a bit of a change. Beginning, it looked like it was definitely in Resnet's favor.
Mm-hmm. Ult from Syndra.
Vi's dropping now. Ezreal may not be able to get away from all three, but he flashes. I'm sorry, that was actually his, is that his E?
I think it is. Yeah, Arcane Shift.
Hecarim so trying to come from the side to get Ezreal. Gets spotted by Riven. They got Hecarim down to half health. Rest of Sex Panther's about to come in. They're able to make it away.
Riven was tanking Hecarim without any trouble.
Yeah. Well, you've seen the fights up top. I mean, Chen and Riven have been basically taking each other. Long fights.
That Hydra, she's got a Ravenous Hydra already. That's going to be nice in team fights.
Sex Panther going for a dragon again. It's definitely going to give them a pretty good gold lead after the kills and the first dragon.
Well, Resident OP is aware of it. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to...
Ezreal, a little early again on the dragon.
Yeah, just a bit. Yeah, Purple's able to get it. Well, pal. Das ist das. Syndra's got pretty nice items for the moment. She's 3-0-1. That Athene's Unholy Grail is going to be great for her mana regen.
Oh, yeah. She's definitely beating Ezreal, I think, at the moment and from the mids.
She's got some decent wave clear with her Q and her E, being able to just wipe through a number of creeps.
Syndra's currently got 161, maybe? Oh, we got to fight at blue. Vi tries to come in for a steal. She's going to fall to Hecarim and Syndra.
That was just bad timing.
Looks like they might try and hit bottom.
The blue.
Syndra trying to come in on Ezreal in mid. Meanwhile, blue abandons bottom.
Yeah, I think they probably made the right decision there.
Hecarim was setting up for the gank.
Yeah, they saw him coming in and decided it was not worth it. Can't blame him for that.
Looks like Sex Panther is setting up to...
That was a pretty good use of Lucian's ult to wave clear, because he knew that the... three enemy champs wouldn't be able to tank the tower on their own. Good decision on his part instead of trying to poke them away from the tower.
Looks like Top's playing their own game again.
Top's always his own game.
Riven and Shen going at it. Shen dropping to a third.
Riven using her ult, not going to be able to use it to its fullest though.
But she's able to get some health here from the minions.
Purple might be able to push bottom. And that tower's gonna be a big help.
Oh, they got four of them here, yeah. Vi setting up to come in. Misses on
I'm not sure she wanted to do that.
Yeah. Shen now porting now to the bottom. Now five for Sex Panther at bottom. Sona's gonna drop there and leaving two dead for ResNet. And they're gonna be able to take bottom now.
Yeah, that's a really big play for ResNet. Gonna give him a tower, not to mention two kills. They could probably get another tower if Shen and Syndra didn't decide to be, which I think they're realizing now.
Sex Panther now 7k up from over ResNet.
Jeez,
actually,
that is
now,
a lot of gold.
Yeah, 7. I think
it looks like
inhibitor.
They're even gonna get an inhibit 29 minutes. That's pretty impressive. Okay, here goes that nib. ResNet, probably going to be able to get a kill out of it, though. If not more. Oh, they might not be able to catch up. Vi should be able to use her Q. Yeah, there's a good punch there. Probably going to get Thinker here, unless Thinker's got a flash. Upper
so
sleeve.
Both at bottom right now. There goes Lulu. And then, Vi is able to get Sivir.
So yeah, getting two kills out of this, not too shabby.
Yeah, catching up for what they lost. Now it looks like Riven.
The board's gonna go down here.
She's maybe gonna not. Need to get away from. Oh, Cinder gets a hit off. So she jumps over into blue. She's gonna be able to escape there.
That was a good escape on her part. Yeah, that would have stunk if they lost those two towers and inhib, and then got two kills back for it, and then lost immediately another kill. Now we're seeing some super creeps coming bottom. Gonna have to defend that. Meanwhile, I think... Yeah, Sex Panther's only really pushed in... I'm sorry, ResNet's only really pushed in top to a base tower. So, they need to figure out when to focus some and get themselves another tower. Hopefully an inhib, too, to balance things out.
They're gonna need, well, they may need the split push and be a little fancy about where they're showing people to Sex Panther. Maybe try and force them to try and do a group fight and lure them into someplace else.
While somebody else takes the tower. Would be the worst idea. Looks like they're gonna lose top here. Blue team's turret has been destroyed. Meanwhile, Syndra waiting just exactly for what Keto's doing.
Yes. There goes Sona. Now down a player. This could be bad. They're probably gonna lose bottom at this point. Can't go into the fight with the tower 4v5 still. So Riven goes in after a Hecarim.
Did some damage there to Finkar. He's about half health. Ooh, she's about quarter health. I can see Riven having some trouble here.
We got a split fight going. Hecarim, nice dodge off, but Lucian gets a kill on Sivir. Oh, I'm sorry. Bai gets the last hit, but Lucian's ulti definitely brought down Sivir's health. Riven now trying to take out Syndra.
Riven needs to use her ult.
Get Syndra. Go. They get Hecarim, they lose Riven. Might be able to get Shen here, but Ezreal is definitely very low. He's able to escape. Now Sona and now the rest of the team all show up and they're able to take out Shen, leaving Lulu behind to defend the base. They need to push here.
Absolutely. That was a great fight. They were able to turn that around pretty well there, take advantage of Thinkar's low health, and then their team's ability to do enough damage so that Riven's ult was able to take out Syndra and also get the rest of the team fairly low. But they appear to be deciding not to push in the least, nor to even defend their top tower, which is going to go. Blue team's turret has been destroyed. So I guess they got a few kills out of it.
Yeah, they're definitely catching up in kills, but they needed to do something there. That was their big moment. They only had a few, maybe about 30 seconds to do something.
Yeah, they could have at least taken the mid tower.
Well, they went for farm. Not the worst. They are behind in gold, but
a tower would have been
more. Or even dragon. I mean, look, Sex Panther's going to take dragon now for the third time. And that's going to boost up their gold. They might be about. Yep, that puts them about 8k now. Difference between ResNet and Sex Panther. Ezreal again, a late. This time late on dragon.
That's a shame.
He's trying. He missed every single one so far, but definitely hard to do.
That mid tower is super low. Sona just begging to get killed. I understand the important awards, but not when it's so easy for you to get jumped and give the enemy teams easy kills. At least be with your teammates.
Looks like they might try and split push here for Sex Panther. They're gonna try and draw them into one lane or the other, and then push the other.
Riven's starting to do some damage. I'll put that to a bit more use.
Setting up close to mid tower there. They don't really have much to worry about with mid tower. It looks pretty low. They just need a couple hits. It looks like, ResNet's definitely got a word there, so they definitely see them. Oh, Vi used her knockup, didn't go anywhere. In the meanwhile, two fights going on. Vi versus three at bot down here in mid, while the rest of their team goes after Sivir and Lulu. This looks like they're just gonna go at Riven. They're losing their main pieces right here. They have Ez, but Sona's dropping down to 100 health. She's gonna drop the Shen, leaving Ezreal and Lucian to defend the base. And now only Lucian.
Oh man, he got away with 185 health. What a shame.
In the meantime, Sivir's able to take out the inhibitor. She's probably gonna take out an inner turret here. Lucian's not gonna be able to stop her, I don't think.
No, this is game. They just don't have enough to defend right now.
Vi is now up using home guard. She's
able to
get a hit up. Get Hecarim's down pretty low. He uses he's getting Shen teleported for the shield. The inner tower is gonna go now.
Oh man.
And here comes Rakata's gotta run. I think she's gonna make it to the fountain. She is. At the same time, Riven gets a kill on Lulu. Not the best. It also gets Hecarim. Sivir's now down to about 100 health. Just needs one more hit. Lucian gets a kill there. But at the meantime, Shen and Syndra are also still teching the Nexus. I don't think they're gonna be able to stop them. They need to get Shen. They get Syndra. Shen could still win this though. He just needs a couple.
He's
one more hit.
In the tower, though.
Oh, he just gets.
Oh my god.
He just gets killed with 100 left in the Nexus.
100. Oh my god. Oh. You know, there was a bit of time there where he just wasn't hitting the tower. I don't know.
He only needed like three more Nexus. Hits.
Blue team agreeing to a surrender regardless. Which is a shame. Would have been entertaining.
And there goes the first round for ResNet versus X-Panther.
I would have actually liked to see them keep playing there, if only to see if they could get a few kills on purple trying to sneak into their base and backdoor. Maybe get them a head up. But, you know,
I think
there's
up,
two more games tonight, so.
Yeah. All right, we're going to be back in about, I think about 10 minutes. We're going to take a little 10-minute break, and then we'll be back with round two.
Let's do it!